So let's just go lane by lane. Let's start with that top lane where, you know, you got champions like Ornn that were disabled or not in the game for 2017 summer. So obviously that's gonna be a totally busted champion, and you've already seen play in competitive. But jumping back to last year in summer 2017 across all the major regions, you got the most played champion in the top lane and the highest win percentage with a minimum 50 games played. And when Jarvan is the most played and has the highest win percentage, you know something is wrong. I mean, he was flexed in the top lane or the jungle, and already, I mean, there's really no big changes where you see him falling out of that top lane or in that jungle spot. So I feel like you're gonna see more of him in 2018, but right now it seems like it's moving more towards those super tank front lines in that top lane. Guys like Ornn, guys like Maokai. I mean, in solo queue, you're looking at Alawi, who I think is gonna be a pick in 2018 because that champion is absolutely insane. In team fights, in 1v2 turnaround fights, even when they're way behind, if you land a really good ultimate, I mean, you are gonna 1v4, 1v5 with that champion. I don't know how many times you've seen people gank in Alawi, 1v2, 1v3, and she gets a kill, two kills, and survives or goes down swinging. So Alawi's maybe a pick to look out for in that top lane, but it's definitely got the vibe that it's gonna be more tank-oriented going forward. But I will say, in that RNG Invictus series, there was a Vladimir sighting, and that looked very terrifying to play against. So I'm sure they're much like different top lane metas. There will be an influx of some carry champions to go along with these tanks, but mostly tanks to start 2018, I'm thinking. Let's head on to the jungle, where the most interesting change for the junglers with these new runes for me was the Predator. It wasn't as good as people thought initially, but they did just buff it in 8.1. So I'm thinking, obviously, a champion like Hecarim is who you immediately think of to use that Predator rune. But even champions like Warwick, maybe an Udyr, I think they could really thrive using that Predator rune. It's definitely not gonna be a common must-have on a lot of these champions, especially just because it's so specific to the champion. But you look at these most played and the win percentage. Gragas, again, top two in both. Insane. He's been so ridiculously entrenched in the meta for so many years. Even when he was AP, then he goes to jungle, then he's top. He goes all over the place, but I'm a little tired of seeing the Gragas. That Zac win percentage, by the way, is obviously a little bit skewed because of a couple of those patches in Season 7 where he was just outright broken OP. So that really bumped up his numbers. But he still played more than 50 games. Champion like Lee Sin, always going to be meta. He's just such a well-balanced champion, such a high skill level that the pros thrive on him. I think a champion like Kha'Zix is going to be more sought after in pick ban going forward in Season 8, just because with these runes he can do so much damage. Some tinkering with his ult and how it affects him going in the bush, in brushes. So I think he's going to be a more highly picked champion going through pick and ban. But I mean, for the most part, it's pretty similar picks to 2017, but I want to see some of these Predator champions come out and play. Let's go to the mid lane, where there's going to be probably some similar picks again. Orianna, much like Lee Sin. She's always going to be picked, doesn't really matter what the meta is. Something like Talia and Corki, I don't see being picked as much. I see mid lane going more into that poke siege type meta, where champions like Xerath just really can dominate the mid game, especially with these runes like Comet, Summon Airy. Maybe the old Ziggs wave clear bot comes back into that mid lane. He's still absolutely disgusting at taking down turrets, so I could see him coming back into the meta. Obviously, Azir is one of the most picked guys in solo queue. You've already seen him banned through a couple of competitive games, so Azir is probably going to be a top pick going forward, as well as the Kassadin. That guy's just terrifying when he gets rolling. LeBlanc right now seems like a weird champion. She kind of has been ever since that rework. I'm not sure how heavily she's going to be involved in pick bans going forward in Season 8, but I think it's going to be more poke focused going forward. Let's go to that bottom lane, where I think the most changes have come from 2017 summer. Obviously, Worlds was the Ardent Sensor meme, the Ardent Sensor meta, which was just probably not fun to do if you're a support. But right now, we are fully immersed in the Relic Shield meta with that excess over shield. It really just, all that's doing is saving some of these champions who have a terrible laning phase and helping them get through it with that extra health, that extra sustain, and a little bit of extra gold with it. And then in the mid game, you're not getting one shot by pretty much anyone. That's why you're seeing a champion like Vayne, most picked AD carry in solo queue. I mean, obviously a late game monster. And when you're not getting smashed in laning phase, which was usually the case with Vayne, it makes it a hell of a lot more fun to play that champion. So Vayne gonna be much more picked up with this Relic Shield stuff. I think Riot's gonna be nerfing that in the coming patches. Someone like Varus and Zaya, maybe even Caitlyn, if laning phase isn't such a big priority anymore, they're probably gonna shift down in the pick ban phase. Tristana, still a super solid pick. Again, that was another weak lane phase champion who now it doesn't really matter. So she's probably gonna move up. Kalista, again, a strong laner that can't really take advantage of it against a lot of these matchups, so maybe she moves down a bit. And obviously, a guy not on this list anywhere to be seen is old Ezreal. Klepto Ez, what a fun time to play against, except not at all. Although I will say, when you have Klepto past like 25 minutes, it's pretty much useless compared to some of these other runes, but just accelerating that, getting that Triforce spike with the mana immune even quicker is so good. So obviously Klepto Ez is gonna be a big pick going forward. Let's look at these supports. Obviously the biggest change that hasn't been announced, or it's been announced but hasn't been implemented yet, is Riot's talking about changing Sightstone into it being built into your support item, so you don't have to go out of your way to build a Sightstone, which is obviously gonna be a huge change, and that probably means some other roles, maybe some more supportive junglers are gonna be buying that item as well, just to have even more vision around the map, which I don't know if that's something Riot will have intended, but we'll see how that plays out going forward. Thresh, the most played, he is basically the Lee Sin of support. Doesn't matter the meta, he's always a solid pick, and when you know how to play him really well, he is a huge advantage and threat to have in that bottom lane. Braum, if poke comps are gonna be the thing going forward, Braum is gonna be a must pick or ban to try and counteract that, just because that unbreakable is such a ridiculous item to have. Tahm Kench, another solid guy to have to save your AD carry. But I think if it's gonna be a poke meta, you're gonna see some more heavy engaged supports to try and break up that support. So guys like the Alistar, something like a Thresh, Blitzcrank with a 60% win rate, you might be seeing a lot more of that, or the Morgana, something to just really force these fights so that the siege comps can't get underway, because that's the only way to break them down. But outside of the bottom lane, I think for the most part, a lot of these picks are so far gonna be pretty similar from 2017, which is very impressive considering how much has changed from season 7 to season 8 with these entirely new runes. But I mean, who knows? Could be totally wrong here. I'm sure at some point someone will discover something crazy with some rune that no one ever runs that becomes meta pretty quickly. One thing I didn't mention about supports is the brand support change. His passive going from 2% of your max health to 4%. They just doubled it with Deathfire Touch out of the game. So, I mean, if some guys are running these tank comps, it helps to have another tank buster at that support position to try and take them out. So maybe Brand becomes a matchup dependent pick in the bottom lane, but that's something to look out for as well. But I mean, the opportunities are endless and you just gotta get creative with your runes. Maybe you can be the next person to discover the next blue build Ezreal or Klepto Nasus, Klepto Ezreal. Who else could you build Klepto on? Who knows? There's a lot of different guys that it could work out on, but season 8 is gonna be the year for experimentation, which is why even some of these top teams that you expect to be at the top, I mean, while you're still figuring out what's actually good, standings could be very up in the air and you don't really know what's going on, which is what makes it so interesting and why Spring Split is so important, to just figure out what the hell you're supposed to build, what champions are supposed to be great, and that's the most interesting time, in my opinion.
Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more esports content.